I use a lot of dialogue in the classroom, and when I say that, it's really where I, as a teacher, am able to question them about their understanding. Because normally if you do a lecture that's a monologue, you've got no idea that the students have understood it. So when I do this dialogue in the classroom, it means I'm checking all my students' understanding, and I'm asking one student to answer me, but the rest of the class are hearing the answers.
It's very good that we can have a chance to learn from other people's mistakes, understand why they are thinking in that way, and also when I have mistakes, others can help correct me without being fed by the teacher what is right and what is wrong.
We provide them worksheets. We get them to do this out of the class. We give them a little bit of time at the beginning to compare their answers to their peers, and they do some peer-to-peer teaching. I'll then go around and I'll ask them questions. So what I do is I change the scenario to challenge them so that they then know how to apply it in a different environment. When they can do that, that means they've got true understanding of the knowledge.
It creates a positive environment for teachers and students to discuss some real cases, and then after we will all discuss as a group and arrive at one treatment plan that we agree on.
I try and create authentic problems that the students may come across. It's student-centered, it's problem-oriented, and interactive. So all of the classes will have some kind of interactive dialogue between me and the student, and it's interactive in that we also get the students to interact with one another before we do the worksheet debriefings. Students will often come to my office and they have a particular clinical problem that they have with a patient and they want to ask me something. Instead of just having a chat and letting them walk out the door and that teaching moment is lost to the rest of the class, and I've recorded these and captured these short one-on-one interactions, put them onto the learning management system, and then I've categorized them with keywords and descriptors so that students can easily find what it is they want to know when they have a similar problem.
Because the students have many different cases which I've never seen before, and through watching these videos I can have an idea on some scenarios that a patient might present with. Sometimes I also watch it with my classmates when preparing for the examination so that we can take down the notes and discuss with each other in case we have any problems.
That's the beauty of online videos too, right? Is that we're not limited to watching in the university. I can watch it anytime, anywhere.
Key skills or competence tests means it gives other students, when it's their turn to take the assessment, they get an almost first-person account of what it's like to experience that assessment. We've recorded all of that, and so students find that really useful in the way that it gives them an insight into a very complex and authentic assessment. So they all consume those videos before they come and take their own assessment for the competence test.
And so usually we'll watch them before exams or preparing for the test, and then we can watch them as a group and discuss with other students and other teachers. We definitely place ourselves in the position of the student and think of the answers ourselves before the student answers, so that we sort of stimulate ourselves to do some critical thinking.
So I think one of our roles as educators is not only transferring knowledge to them, but it's doing it in a challenging way that makes them think, why is it important and how do I apply it in different contexts, such that then it will make their life easier when they're treating their patients, and it means ultimately they'll be able to provide better patient care when they're on the clinics.